are today in India, in the southern part of India, in the state of Tamil Nadu, and 30 kilometers from the historic town of Tanjavur, where 1,000 years ago magnificent temples were built and bronzes cast by the famous Chola dynasty of the 10th century. And here in Swanimalai, 30 kilometers away from Tanjore or Tanjavur, this tradition of making bronzes still survives in this little village of Swanimalai. And we are now in the workshop of Devasena Sthapathi, one of the reputed families of traditional bronze casters.
Soften the wax. Bring me it over so that there are no flaws.
So a very crucial process is this whole matter of carving the wax model, almost sculpting it really. So it's a process of sculpting wax. And so all the details are first sculpted onto the wax, and then the wax is melted out, and that's really what the Sireperji process is. That is, it's first encased in three layers of clay to make a mold, and then the wax is melted out so that it leaves a hollow in the shape of the metal to be cast. And then the bronze metal is poured inside to give the casting. And then the mold is broken and the metal icon is retrieved. And in this process, each icon which is made is unique, because it is the unique specifications and the shaping of the wax model that results in the icon. So in that way, it's not a replication process.
Measurement ella panni eppadi pandrenga wax model?
Wax model vandu adu naanga vandu enna uyaramo andha uyarathu thanna olaiyila idhu pola andha thanna olaiyila eduthirrom.
He uses a palm frond, frond of the coconut tree.
Karona sumar recording aayidhu.
And this is used for marking out the proportions of the icon.
Thenna maram thana?
Thenna maram.
Coconut, which is thenna. And then
இது வந்து என்ன பண்றேனா இந்த ஃபீமே மேல் ஃபிகரா இருந்தா இத 124 பாகம் பண்றோம் 124 பார்ட் 124 பார்ட் பண்றோம் ஃபீமேல இருந்தனாக 120 பார்ட் பண்றோம்
ஓ ஹி சேஸ் தட் ஃபார் எ மேல் ஃபிகர் ஹி யூசஸ் 124 பார்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃபார் தி ஃபீமேல் ஃபிகர் 120
பார்ட்ஸ்
அப்படினா இது சின்ன சின்னதா 120 ல பண்ணுவீங்களா
இத நான் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கதே 120 பார்ட் தான் பண்றேன்
அது
இந்த லல்லாடம்
This is the forehead.
Face.
Face.
கழுத்து வந்துருது.
Neck.
இது மார்பு.
Torso, chest.
நாபி.
Navel.
இது வந்து மேட்டர் வந்து தொடை இங்க வந்துருது.
Coming to the top of the thigh.
அது போல பாதம் இங்க வந்துருது. அது போல ஒவ்வொரு இடத்துக்குமே மெஷர்மென்ட் இருக்குமா? இது ரெண்டே கால் பங்கு.
So this is 2.5
தொடையினுடைய பகுதி.
இதோடியே எல்லாம் பண்ணிக்கலாம்
இதே மெஷர்மென்ட் இப்ப இதே மெஷர்மென்ட் தான் கைக்கு வந்திருக்கு
and the same measurement for the hand so he's making here the Nataraja image as you can see this shows the fire of destruction of Nataraja and this is the drum of creation and he's dancing on the demon dwarf Apasmara so he has made this separately and he will join this and then the prabha will be made the ring of fire will be made separately and joined and the ornaments are made of in the grade of wax chellungo
idu vandu honey wax mix panirukom
peace wax
ama peace wax so idu soft wax irukanaala da ornament la adu pandrom
made of soft wax which is of beeswax
beeswax
and this is of harder
hard wax,
wax.
Paraffin wax mix
this has got paraffin wax and beeswax so there are different grades of wax that he uses One very crucial process is that of attaching the runners because metal is, although it's molten, it doesn't flow very easily. So he's showing here how the process of joining runners to make the metal more castable is done.
Thank you. கேட்டோட போல அப்படி வரும் இந்த மண்
ஆமா
ஆத்துல இருக்கு ஆத்துல தான் கிடைக்கும் அது
ஆத்துலனா நம்ம இது அங்க ஒன்னு மோல்ட் இருக்கு அதுவும் அதே மாதிரி பண்ணியாச்சு so this is our third day here when we are passing through Swamimalai again and we are looking here at the stage when the wax model has been made you can see the runners of wax also one is a screw another is one is for pouring metal one is for the escape of gases so there are two one vent and one screw and the whole mold has been covered with iron band so that it won't burst and things to consolidate it so that's exactly what we're seeing over here and now they're getting ready to melt the wax out that's what they're going to do okay oh this process we should see As such, the lost wax technique has quite an ancient history. I mean, in the Indian subcontinent alone, it is thought that the very fine Mohenjo-daro dancing girl, dating back to about 2500 BC, may have been made by the lost wax process. But of course, there was a big break, and it's really from the early centuries AD that images started to be cast very widely in India for Hindu, Buddhist and Jain purposes under the dynasties such as the Guptas and then the Pallavas in the 8th century and then the Cholas in the 10th century. And in a sense, to some extent, the iconographic conventions have remained to a large extent the same over the past thousands of years because they followed religious texts called the Shilpa Shastras, which gave very specific, very detailed specifications on the ways the iconography of the gods and the goddesses should be portrayed. You know, the pose of Parvati and the dance of Shiva and all of the Nataraja pose. And that is the Hindu god Shiva as a lord of dance, and then Parvati, that is the consort. And so many of these iconographic conventions and the mudras or the hand gestures, which are also used in the classical dance traditions, those have remained the same. But we still maintain that the Chola and Pallavas made the best bronzes, which they don't replicate those anymore. In the Thanjavur Art Gallery in the historic city of Tanjore, the capital of the Chola dynasties back around the 10th to 11th century, and we are looking at the celebrated Nataraja bronze images for which this dynasty has been most famous. And I first came here in 1990 as part of my PhD thesis when I was investigating the way these images were made, and I'd also visited Swami Malay and visited the methods of making images even today. And to just explain briefly the iconography of the Nataraja bronze, as you can see, there is this representation of the so-called cosmic dance of creation and destruction, where the drum is held in the right hand, the drum of creation, and the fire of destruction is held in the other hand of the dancing Hindu god Shiva. And around him are the cycles of perpetual creation and destruction represented by fire. And underfoot is the dwarf demon or Apasmara, who is quelled. And so this represents the universe in cosmic order, whereby forces of creation and destruction are balanced and the forces of good and evil kept at bay. And these are the five activities of the dancing Hindu god Shiva. Hey, 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 hey